gratitude goes to God Almighty, who in His infinite mercies made it possible for me to be a member of the Sixth Assembly, which started on the 11th of June 2015. As if that wasn't enough, by the grace of my colleagues, I became the pioneer speaker of the Assembly, wherein I served for 18 months. Mr. Speaker, I want to thank the people of Isialamba North who deemed it fit and proper to bring me back to the House of Assembly for a third time. My appreciation goes to the leadership of the Assembly, led by no less a person than the man who is sitting on the green chair, the reputable legal practitioner, who has today become an accomplished legislator, the number one legislator in Abia State as of today. My appreciation goes to the Deputy Speaker and the entire leadership for the bond of friendship and brotherhood that crystallized amongst us within the year under review. Let me thank indeed every other of my colleagues who have extended their hands of fellowship to me while we serve. I cannot end this appreciation without thanking the staff and management of the Assembly, led by Mr. Clark, the Deputy Clerk, and of course the clerks at the table, the staff of the office of Mr. Speaker, who served me and tolerated me for 18 months, even when I would be in the office past working hours for civil servants. I also want to thank my committee secretary, Mrs. Chibuz Okal, who made sure that we were effective in the Committee of Justice and Judiciary. Mr. Speaker, saving the best for last in my appreciation is to thank my family, wonderful wife and five kids, who made sacrifices and continues to make for me to leave the road every other day, at times coming back very late, leaving in the morning, and they tolerated all of that. I want to thank them. I want to thank all the people that served me as aides in the Sixth Assembly. If there was any modest achievement I made, it was due to all that they did to support me. Having said this, by word of appreciation, Mr. Speaker, the Valedictory section affords us an opportunity for peer review, overview of what we have done in the Assembly for 4 years, both individually and corporately. And you have alluded to most of them. And I want to add or continue from where you stopped, from the hindsight of our core mandates as parliament, which is lawmaking, representation, and oversight. Mr. Speaker, in the area of lawmaking, I want to beat my chest to say that I did my best authoring laws, joining other members to author laws, motions, matters of urgent public importance, petitions, and what have you. I do not want to bore this session with details of the laws I authored. As at the last time I looked at it, is in the region of about 20, and I did not need to go through them. But I want to say, sir, that the Sixth Assembly, if I am asked to score us, I will say that we can attain 95% in the area of lawmaking through both executive bills and private member bills. And most of these bills were passed into law. A few were not assented to, great majority of them assented to. Some were not passed. And that is why when the 7th Assembly comes, like you said, they will continue from where we stopped. Mr. Speaker, in the area of representation, it's my considered opinion that we did well being the voice of our people on in these hallowed chambers, standing solidly for them, even when they are maltreated, making various interventions for them, both in public and in private. Our members who spoke earlier have alluded to this, from empowerment to every other thing we did. Mr. Speaker, I also want to say that you sincerely did not lag behind in that area. From medical to education to empowerment to employment and what have you, to road grading, rehabilitation, and construction, I did all of that, and so every other colleague of ours, standing solidly for those who sent us to the assembly. And to that extent, I want to also score us a pass mark in that regard. Mr. Speaker, oversight. Mr. Speaker, even though I will get criticized by my colleagues, but I want to be truthful because a session like this should enable us to x-ray our strengths so that those coming behind us can build on them, our weaknesses so that they can properly situate it and overcome it. Mr. Speaker, I want to say without fear of contradiction that this is one area as an assembly we did not do well. We did not use the instrument of oversight to ensure that governance will give to agents all that they expected from us. Against the background, when we came into power, there was high expectation from everybody that this government will buy everything the other masses send them to buy in the market. And that is why, Mr. Speaker, as I bow out today, do I have concerns? Yes, I have concerns. My concern stems from the fact of the ineffective oversight that we did, which culminated in our not finding legislative solutions to issues that plagued the state. And it is because of that, Mr. Speaker, opinion mine, that today, because of the challenges of payment of salaries, we now have a dichotomy between core civil servants and parastatal civil servants. Mr. Speaker, this House did not rise to that occasion to ask what happened. Mr. Speaker, it is because of the absence of oversight that we did not empathize enough for our pensioners, and a lot of them are dying daily. We did not ask questions. Mr. Speaker, the environmental challenges in Omai has a state capital, especially the menace at EC Gate, wherein this assembly sponsored and passed into law a bill prohibiting such acts. We were not able to find legislative solutions to that. I can go on and on and on, but I need to stop at that point. Just to say that for the coming assembly, for every government to deliver on its mandate, there ought to be a proactive and a responsive parliament. A parliament that will be passionate, a parliament that will have the moral courage to stand for the Abia masses. And I say this to challenge the incoming assembly, for them to build on our strengths and also improve on our shortcomings and weaknesses. Having said this, Mr. Speaker, I want to say, just like you have said earlier on, that for everything that has a beginning, there must be an end. And to allude to that, I want to borrow the words of Shakespeare in his popular work As You Like It, when he said, all the world is a stage, and all the men and women are mere players. They all have their entrances and their aces, and one man in his time playing many parts. His acts, if good, lasting for ages. The beauty of the parliament, Mr. Speaker, is that everything we have done here is recorded. And everybody, even in 20 years' time, anybody who wants to know can pick up the answers and look at the contributions that every member made on every given issue, on every deal, on every petition, and on every matter of urgent public importance. And it is in line with these words. When they look, are they going to find some of the things we did lasting for ages, bringing peace and unity for the Abha people, driving development? Mr. Speaker, my concern, after 20 years of unbroken democracy and 4 years of our outgoing administration, it is hard to find a signature project that we can say, this is what we began and this is what we completed in the life of the outgoing government. So it is a moment for sober reflection, a moment for stock-taking, so that our story as Abha people can be better. It's my prayer and my wish that our government, the 7th Assembly, and by extension, this present government, led by Dr. Okezie, Ikpeazu, will do better than what we did in the outgoing government, so that Abhans can leave a sigh of relief, so that our people, other people can also say, as they say now, go to a Ebonyi state and see what is happening. We would like that in the next 4 years, that people will say, go to Abha state and see the mirror that is going on there. Having said that, for returning members, do your best, because the world is watching. For outgoing members, I want to tell us that there is a place called forward. Let us continue to embrace it, for our tomorrow shall certainly be better than our today. And like the two choristers who are in the same bracket with me, and I also want to take a cue from them, and that is to sing that.